Hello everybody and welcome back to another video. Now in today's video we're going to be doing yet another Windows related experiment, and this one I think is actually going to be kind of fun. You guys may have seen in my last video on that virtual machineception where I basically tried to install a bunch of different layers of different virtual machines inside of other virtual machines, and that video did very well, and it kind of got me thinking to take a little bit of a different approach to that. And what we're going to be doing today is, as I install Sun VirtualBox here, we're going to be trying to install Windows 10 inside of Windows XP. And so yeah, we're going to be trying this out in today's video and just see if we can actually do this and how it's actually going to work. Now, the kind of funny thing that you guys can probably tell, because this looks like a very similar setup to a lot of my videos, is we're already inside of a virtual machine right now. So I'm, you know, recording this video on my Windows 10 host computer, and we have a Windows XP virtual machine set up here. So we're basically going to be trying to install another layer, you know, another virtual machine, which is going to be Windows 10 inside of this virtual machine. So it's a little bit of a VMception as well. But the added challenge is that we're trying to install a newer OS on an older OS as opposed to the other way around like it usually is. And the added challenge for us here as well, an additional challenge, is that we are using a 32-bit release of Windows XP, which is pretty typical. I mean, most versions of XP were 32-bit. There was a 64-bit release that wasn't really as popular. But the reason why that's going to kind of add a bit of an issue for us is because we're only limited to 4 gigabytes of memory that the system can actually use. So I've maxed that out. We are using 4 gigs of RAM in this virtual machine. So we're only going to be able to allocate probably half of the memory, so that would be 2 gigabytes, to the Windows 10 virtual machine. So we're going to be trying that out. I assume this is going to work because I actually did this. Of course, it was with Windows 7, but back when I ran a Windows Vista install on one of my older computers, I actually, you know, did a couple of videos on Windows 7, and I installed Windows 7 in a VM, and it worked totally fine. I mean, why wouldn't it? But we're just going to be seeing if we run into any issues. But let's just go ahead, and this is kind of funny that this is such an old release of VirtualBox here. This is the same one that I did in that XP mode video, and the latest Windows release at this time was Windows 7. So we're just going to choose that as the preset, and we're going to give the machine. Actually, I wonder if it's even going to allow us to put. It's actually, oh my gosh, it's not going to allow us to put 2 gigabytes. I wonder if we can set other windows. Yeah, it's actually maxing out at 1,500 megabytes. So that's about 1.5 gigs of RAM. That's like, it will not go further than that. That's actually very interesting. So we're going to basically give this the maximum amount of memory that it will allow us to give it. I wonder if that's a preset thing. Like, I wonder if we just choose other and other, if it will. No, that is still the same thing. So that is interesting. That probably has something to do with, you know, this being once again a 32-bit program. So yeah, that is actually going to add another bit of a challenge to us as well. Let's see if VirtualBox will even allow us to max this out, because it might do what it did in that previous video and say there's kind of undesirable conditions, you know, because you're using too much memory for the VM. So we're going to try that out. It says that the recommended size of the hard disk is 20 gigs. I think I gave this machine a 40 gig hard drive. Actually, I gave it 20 gigs. I might actually have to increase that. All right, so we're back, and I have increased the XP machine's hard drive to 40 gigabytes, and I actually had to use EaseUS Partition Master to accomplish that, which was great. So yeah, the VM, this XP VM now has a 40 gig drive. Then I created a Windows 10 VM here using the Windows 7 preset, gave it 1.5 gigs of memory as well as a 25 gigabyte hard drive. So this was the maximum amount of memory, as I said before, that VirtualBox actually allows me to give it. So now what we're going to do is go in here to storage, and we're going to mount the ISO file that I have on the desktop right here. So we're going to hit OK, select, and hopefully if everything works, we should be able to boot from this and actually install Windows 10 without any problems. But let's see if it actually goes that way, because there's probably going to be at least one thing that doesn't go according to plan. So let's just see here. Okay, so it's saying it's optimized to work in 32-bit color mode. Display, yeah, that's fine. That's just one of VirtualBox wonderful messages there. It's not actually able to like display the entire screen on like, you know, all at once, like, it's, you know, got all these different scrolls. What the heck? Oh, okay. Oh, well, this is, so, yeah, this apparently is a 64-bit image, so obviously that really isn't going to work, so because it just straight up tells you this 64-bit application couldn't load because your PC doesn't have a 64-bit processor. Okay, so yeah, a slight mishap there. I kind of thought that that ISO image that I had was one of those, like, dual ones where it had both 32-bit and 64-bit, like, you know, you could choose from either one. So now I have downloaded a 32-bit only image, so we should be able to actually boot from it this time, which would be helpful. And yeah, let's see if we can actually get this installed. I'm sure that some of you guys will be saying down in the comments, like, why on earth are you trying this? Because there is literally no, like, reason for me to be doing this other than just to see if we can actually do it. That's basically the only reason why I'm doing this. I'm already running Windows 10 on my host computer, so, like, in a use case scenario, there's no real need for me to install Windows 10 inside of a VM that I'm already running on my Windows 10 computer. But it's just for you guys and just to see if we can actually accomplish this on video. That's why I'm doing this. So we're just going to let Windows 10 boot up here. It is definitely taking a decent amount of time. The, like, you know, spinning spiral hasn't even started yet. So that's definitely, you know, taking longer than it usually does, at least from my experience. But that is probably because we're going through two virtualization layers and the RAM has been cut to 2 gigabytes, and, or actually not even 2 gigabytes, it's like 1.5 gigs of RAM. So hopefully we'll get somewhere, but we will see. Alright, so actually to my surprise, we weren't able to install Windows 10 inside of this version of VirtualBox right here. Basically what was happening is the OS was actually freezing on the initial boot phase and it was not going past that. I actually tried to install VMware Player, but the version, like the oldest version that I was able to find, needed a 64-bit processor, which obviously we don't have. Okay, so I just want to interrupt this video very briefly here because I want to touch on some other things that I've been trying to do. And you can probably see by what we have set up here, I was actually able to find a copy of VMware that works under Windows XP. This right here is actually VMware Player, I believe it's version 3.0. And I have tried to run this, I was able to run it under VMware Player on my host computer, and right now I've set up a whole new XP VM in VirtualBox. And let me just show you what happens when we actually try to run Windows 10 here. We get a bit of a different result, and I want to kind of briefly show you what happens here. It doesn't just hang, but it actually gets caught in a boot loop, and basically what happens is it still does not show the actual, like, wheel, like the actual, you know, progress wheel, like it usually does when it boots up. It just does that. It just immediately, like, resets the VM. Another thing that was happening when I actually tried to run this in the other VMware Player virtual machine on my host computer, I would also get an unexpected kernel mode trap error. It would actually show a blue screen of death, and then it would restart, and we get, like, caught in that boot loop. And looking up that error, it actually corresponds, or one of the things that it could correspond to, is a hardware problem. So I'm thinking that, you know, that definitely has, you know, something to do with the multiple virtualization layers. I even tried modifying some settings in the actual VMX file itself on my host computer, and modifying the processor settings on that as well, and that didn't fix anything either. I would think, and I'm going to actually possibly try this in a future video, that actually running this on, like, regular hardware, like a regular XP laptop, might actually work, because it wouldn't have to be going through multiple virtualization layers. It might still not work, but if you guys want to see, like, another attempt, be sure to actually let me know down in the comments. But yeah, I have gone through here and tried to, like, you know, go through all of these options here. I have tried to actually install, what you're going to see, I've tried to install a couple of other different virtual machine softwares. Well, mainly VirtualPC was the only other one that I tried. And then I actually took a little bit of a different approach, and I'm just going to let my past self explain that to you in this next clip. So yeah, unfortunately, using VMware Player did not work either. So yeah, kind of sucks, but let's just move on to some other attempts. So we're going to try a couple of different things. The first thing we're going to try is to install VirtualPC 2007, which I know will work on Windows XP. This is going to be kind of a long shot. I don't think that we'll be able to install it in here because we weren't able to do it in VirtualBox. I'd be very surprised if it actually worked, but we're just going to be trying it to see if it yields us any different results. And if this doesn't work, which I think it's not going to, we're going to actually move on and actually go down one release from Windows 10 to Windows 8.1, and we're going to try to install that and see if we can get that to work. For whatever reason, VirtualPC here is taking its sweet time to go to the next screen. You can see that this phase is already done. The bar has gone all the way across. For some reason, it's just not wanting to move to the next screen. So we're just going to wait on that. You can see that the actual icon has showed up in the... Oh, look at that. We can actually... Oh, there we go. Okay, so I think it's done now. No, it's not. Well, we can actually run the program. So we're going to actually create a new VM, which has already popped up, actually. And we're going to go next. We're going to create a new virtual machine. We're going to call this Win10 Second Attempt. If I can spell correctly, we'll hit next here. We're going to we'll just choose other because there's only like the highest thing is Windows Vista. So we'll just go with other here, and you know, configure the RAM ourselves. I actually don't know how. Oh, it looks like we can actually give it more than 1.5 gigs of RAM like VirtualBox did. So we'll actually give this 2 gigs right on the dot, so 2048. And hit next. We're going to use a new virtual hard disk. We will give this 20 gigs, so about 20,000. I know that isn't exact, but we'll just give it 20,000 megabytes. Hit next, finish. Literally don't know what's going on with this setup wizard. It's literally taking forever. We're just not going to worry about that for now. And we're going to go into our CD drive, and we're going, actually, it's been a while since I've used VirtualPC, you can tell. You have to actually do it from... once you actually start the VM up here, you have to capture ISO image, and we're going to capture this 1903 x86, which is Windows 10 version 1903. So we'll capture that and see if it actually works here, which I'm sure it's going to be able to boot from the CD totally fine. I just think it's going to actually not want to get past this phase, which is basically what VirtualBox did as well. So we'll let it sit on this screen for a little bit here and hope that it does something different, but I highly doubt that it's going to actually work. Alright, yeah, so it's been a little bit here and we have not gotten anywhere. So that is kind of what I thought was going to happen. It's not a good sign, but we're not going to give up just yet. Like I said, we do have another plan here. It's not going to be Windows 10, but it will be somewhat close to Windows 10. I still have no idea what's going on with this setup here. We'll just cancel the installation, if it even allows us to do that. Or it'll just sit here for the rest of the video. That's totally fine with me. But yeah, we're going to actually try out the Windows 8 ISO file, or the Windows 8.1 file that I have downloaded. We're going to see if that gives us any different results. So this is a 32-bit copy of Windows 8.1. Obviously, it's English. So we're going to keep it with the same settings that we gave the other VM, you know, like the Windows 10 one. So that's going to be 1.5 gigs of RAM. So we'll go ahead and just power this on and see if we get any better results, which I think that we will. But of course, I'm not 100% sure, but let's just hope for the best. So we've got that same boot screen here. And okay, so we've actually got something different happening. At least it actually did something this time. Instead of just hanging like Windows 10 did, it actually gave us an error code. It says that your PC needs to restart. And VirtualBox has come up with a guru meditation. A critical error has occurred while running the virtual machine and the machine execution has been stopped. Okay, well, that was a quick fail. We've actually gone back one more release to Windows 8, and we're actually running the Windows 8 release preview here because it's the latest ISO file that I actually had downloaded. So we'll see if this gives us any different results. I was kind of hoping we'd be getting better results at the moment than what we're actually getting. Okay, so that also didn't work. It gave us a very similar error code up here with all of these parameters here. So yeah, I'm kind of disappointed. I thought we were gonna get like some better results, but apparently you can't really run Windows 10 inside of Windows XP, at least in the setup that I have here. It might be if I tried this on like a physical piece of hardware, you know, where it's not going through a virtualization layer, it might actually work. But I think for now, guys, that is actually going to go ahead and end it off for this video. Yeah, wasn't really the results that I wanted. I'm sure you guys wanted to actually see this working, but we do have these videos where occasionally things just don't work out as planned. But hopefully this was still somewhat enjoyable for you guys. And if it was, definitely sure to give this one a thumbs up. Be sure to get subscribed down below and turn on those channel notifications if you haven't already to get notified whenever that I upload a new video, which I do every single week on this channel. And as always, guys, I just want to thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you all in the next video.